Hi, my name is Sergey. Welcome back to Data Studio series by Railsware Academy. I promise you that after this short video, you will know how to get more out of your data with the help of data blending and calculated fields features. In the Data Studio tutorial, which you can find here, we worked with only one table as a data source. But what if there are two or more sources? For this purpose, there is a nice feature called data blending, which allows you to merge data from multiple sources into a single one and connect it to any visual objects like chart, tables, scorecards, filters, etc. As a showcase, we'll work with the recruitment dashboard. This dashboard represents statistics on candidates' salary expectations from different countries. We get this data from the applicants filter data source, which is already connected to the report. In addition to the represented data, we constantly run a survey, which helps us to collect information about the recruitment channel. Let's integrate it into our report. To learn the Data Studio basics, watch our initial tutorial by clicking the card above. Firstly, create a new data source. Click Resources, Manage Edit Data Sources, Add a Data Source, choose Google Sheets, choose the needed file and a tab, in our case it's Recruitment Channels, connect, rename it to Recruitment Channels, add to report. Let's give a bit of space for the future Recruitment Channels pie chart. To add a pie chart, click Add a chart, pie chart, and drop it to the report field. Pick the recruitment channel's data source and set up dimensions and metrics. Pick source as a dimension. Pick count of applicant ID as a metric. And sort by count applicant ID. This new chart represents applicants' distribution across the recruitment channels. For better visibility, I'll go to style and change the percentage to values. As we see, Glassdoor is the most powerful source of candidates for us, while job boards are in second place. Now let's go to the view mode and try to filter results by a position data analyst. As you can see, the table, map, the bar chart were updated, while the pie chart was not. This happens because there is no connection between those two data sources. To make things work well, we will use the data blend feature. Go to Resources, Manage Blended Data, Add a Data View. Choose Applicants Filter. Click Add another data source. Choose Recruitment Channel. As you can see, there is a possibility to add more sources in a single view. For this showcase, two will be enough. Name the view Applicants Recruitment Channels. Choose Applicant ID as a join key for both data sources. If the name of the keys are identical, data source will automatically pick proper key for the second data source. If the names are different, you can choose the field manually. In our case, the names are the same, and it simplifies the flow. Add dimensions and metrics. We'll need the count of applicant IDs and sources. Don't forget to add application date to a date range, so the data filters work for this view. Click Save. Click Close to get back to the dashboard. Update data source for the pie chart by choosing the newly created data source from the list. There is a special icon for a blended data views. If you don't find your newly created view, just refresh the whole page of the browser and it will appear. The pie chart will most probably get broken, no worries. Go back to the chart settings and pick the correct dimensions and metrics once more. Let's check if filters work properly now for all of the objects. Let's go to the view mode and choose data analyst position. The table and the charts are updated. If we change the position to a full stack engineer, numbers will also get updated. And what about the date range? Change it to a different range and all the charts will get updated too. Note that we have updated data source only for the pie chart, while table, map, bar chart, and filters are still connected to the applicant's filter data source, and it works well. If you want to change something in the blended view, go to Resources, Manage Blended Data, pick the view to edit. Now let's have a look at one more Data Studio feature to help you to get even more from your data, called calculated fields. Often happens that the original data source contains a lot of information but not always in the format you need. Or sometimes you just want to calculate additional metrics required to a specific report. Let's create a few calculated fields that can be helpful for our dashboard. Choose any objects and create those fields by clicking Create New Field in the bottom right corner. Or you go to Resources, Manage Edit Data Sources, Edit Applicants Filter, Add a Field in the top right corner. I'd like to see the application's distribution over the weekdays. I create a new field, let's name it Weekday. In the formula area, type Weekday. This is a standard function in Data Studio, so once you start typing it, the drop-down list will appear and you can choose the correct function. Select application date as a parameter. As you see, there is also an after-completion list of metrics and dimensions. All new calculated fields will also appear in the drop-down list. Click Save, Done. Documentation tells us days are counted from Sunday and the value of Sunday is 0, therefore the value of Saturday is 6. Let's update the existing bar chart. We'll use applicants filter as a data source. Replace dimension position with the weekday. Count of applicant IDs as a metric. Sort by weekday ascending. Let's also go to style and show data labels for convenience. Seeing numbers on x-axis is good, but I want to see the day names for better readability. For this, I'll use the case condition. It's not the most elegant solution, but it's good for the demo purpose. Let's create a new calculated fields in applicants filter data source and name it weekday string. I have already prepared the formula, so I'll copy and paste it in the new field. Case statements let you create new fields that use conditional logic to determine the field values. Case is the most often used to create new categories or groupings of data. When then is a part of case syntax. It allows you to state if the weekday is equal to 1, then we return Monday, 2, Tuesday, and so on. And is the mandatory closing reserved word. What's wrong? Why doesn't it work? The answer is simple. Weekday with application date as a parameter is a function call, and calculated fields don't support function calls inside of the case statement. To be honest, the formulas you can write in Data Studio are quite limited, so you need a bit of practice to understand what works and what doesn't. We need to change this formula to a correct one. To avoid using function calls inside of the case, we will use the field workday created at the previous step. I already have code snippet with the correct formula in my notes. You see the green tick icon in the bottom here, which indicates that the formula is correct. Click Save and Done. Now select the bar chart again and replace weekday with weekday string in the dimensions field. And now the applicant's distribution is represented the way we want it to. This dashboard was created with the help of Coupler.io, a service that helps to transfer data safely between various platforms like G Sheet, Xero, HubSpot, and many more. Check it out in the case you want to build smooth data flows and have analytics at your fingertips. I hope I've kept my promise and you have discovered something useful today. Don't forget to check the practice file with the dataset in the description. That's all for today. Goodbye!